Hey everyone, welcome to Sidetrack Adventures. This is Steve. Right now I'm on Route 66 in Newberry Springs, California, and behind me is the Bagdad Cafe. Now this place became kind of famous after a 1988 movie also called Bagdad Cafe, but up until that point, it was known as the Sidewinder Cafe. The original Bagdad Cafe was long gone by that point. It was located about 50 miles east of here in Bagdad, California. And that brings us to what we're doing in today's video. Today, we're gonna head east and visit the Route 66 ghost towns of Siberia and Bagdad. Both of the places we're gonna visit today got their start in 1883, when the Atchison, Topeka, and Santa Fe Railway was built between Needles and Barstow, California. The railroad would build stops in roughly 10-minute increments through the desert, so the steam engines of the time could take on water. Whoever was coming up with the names for the railroad stops must have had a pretty good sense of humor, giving places in the Mojave Desert names such as Arctic, Klondike, and Siberia. Other stops got exotic names like Siam, Bengal, and Baghdad. After the arrival of the trains, within a few years, a number of mines opened in the area, bringing in more people. While the mines brought an initial boon, they began to dry up quickly. Luckily, around the same time the mines began to go dry, automobiles began to arrive, first on the National Old Trails Road, then on Route 66. Unfortunately, with the end of the steam engine, trains no longer needed to make so many stops, and a lot of towns began their decline. The bypassing of Route 66 by Interstate 40 in the early 1970s was the final nail in the coffin. We've made it to the icy, frozen tundra of Siberia. And by icy, frozen tundra, I mean hot, dry desert. But this is Siberia, California, or what's left of it at least. This tire is the only thing on Route 66 that marks the town's location. Siberia was the smaller of the two towns we're visiting today. The town did have a couple of service stations and a cafe in the 1930s and early 1940s, but I believe this was a railroad building. I'm not sure what this hole is. Hopefully it's not where the toilet was, but let's take a look inside. The end of the steam engine effectively killed this town. By the mid-1940s, this place wasn't even mentioned in the Route 66 guidebooks. It looks like the town has at least one resident still. In the early 1900s, this must have been a miserable place to live. There was a poem published in the newspaper in 1912 by a man who lived in Siberia named Robert E. Lee, presumably no relation to the Civil War general. Siberia is referred to in the poem as "the land where the gaunt vulture of despair flaps his huge wings, and hope sinks into oblivion, where memories seem vague and daydreams die." Not exactly something most places would put on their tourist brochures. We've moved across Route 66 to the south side. And here are the foundations for one of the service stations that used to operate in Siberia. This service station probably closed in the 1940s. There was another service station that I actually have a picture of that was on the north side of Route 66 right before you get to where you turn off to head into Siberia. And you can see here where the gas pumps were. Foundations for the buildings. This place was actually a decent size. You could tell there were a number of buildings here. I believe this is where the auto camp was as well, but I'm not 100% sure on that. And behind it, nothing but desert for miles. But let's head to Baghdad. Real quick, before we get to where the town of Baghdad once was, the area around the town has unfortunately seen a couple of military tragedies over the years. Located about 200 feet south of Route 66, you could find a monument to one of those tragedies. This is where the Baghdad Auxiliary Airfield was located. On April 9th, 1942, a U.S. Army Air Force AT-7 Navigator crashed here during a training exercise, killing all five crew members on board. The plane hit the desert short of the runway and cartwheeled for 250 yards. It was said the wreckage was spread out over a quarter mile. The other tragedy ended about a mile down this road, and it's such a sad story of failed leadership. Lance Corporal Jason Rother was a 19-year-old Marine who was posted as a road guide in August 1988. The officer in charge, Lieutenant Alan Lawson, disobeyed the order to place road guides in pairs, got lost, forgot where he had placed Lance Corporal Rother, and upon the completion of the exercise, failed to mention that Rother was missing, as did two sergeants responsible for Lance Corporal Rother. Temperatures during the day reached up to 107 degrees, and over 40 hours had passed without anyone in the battalion saying that Rother was missing. When finally, something was said when an inventory of the armory revealed Lance Corporal Rother's weapon hadn't been turned in. A massive search was undertaken for Lance Corporal Rother, but unfortunately his remains weren't found until December. He had walked 17 miles before perishing, making it to within 1 mile of Route 66. Lieutenant Lawson was court-martialed and spent 4 months in the brig. This incident is still used in the military today as a lesson about the importance of accountability and responsibility. We've made it to where the town of Baghdad once was, and according to a sign, this tree is the last thing that remains of Baghdad. But not quite. This tamarisk tree is the only thing you could see from Route 66, and the last survivor of Baghdad, which was a pretty decent-sized town out here at one point. You can see the tree in some of the old photos of the town. This postcard is from 1939, and it mentions to see Dave when you're in town. I always thought that was funny. Hopefully there was only one Dave in town at the time. I recently came across another postcard though, and this postcard is of Dave. I did look to see if I could find more info on Dave, but unfortunately, I wasn't able to find anything. But here's Dave, the most famous person from Baghdad. This tree is pretty hardy. Baghdad has always been one of the driest places in the United States. It recorded the longest period of drought anywhere in the history of the country, from July 1912 to November 1914, 767 consecutive days without rain. We started this video at the Baghdad Cafe in Newberry Springs. The original Baghdad Cafe was located here, and it was the social center of the desert in the area. From the 1940s through the 1950s, the Baghdad Cafe was the place to gather on a Saturday night, being the only place in the area with a jukebox and a dance floor. It was the entertainment capital of the Mojave Desert between Needles and Barstow. You can see some of the old asphalt and concrete from the town here and there. Here's some of the concrete right here. But let's head over to the train tracks. There was a Santa Fe station here, and even a Harvey House. But the station was closed by 1943. And here are some of the pieces of the town. Right behind the pile of cement, we have a pile of metal. But after this train goes by, we're gonna head to the other side of the train tracks to find the Baghdad Cemetery. Despite the town being long gone, there's still a sign for Baghdad along the train tracks. There are the train tracks to our south, and right over here is where we're going. Looks like we may have come across the town dump. There is broken bottles and pottery and just random pieces of metal everywhere. You can see an old style bottle right here, at least the top of it, next to a just chunk of metal. Cans. And looks like somebody may have dug this up, probably treasure hunting. But let's head to the cemetery. So here's the Baghdad Cemetery. As many as 50 Chinese rail workers died here of cholera in the 1800s, but none are buried in this cemetery. They are all buried somewhere in the desert in unmarked graves. These graves might be marked, but it's unknown who's buried in them. A fire in 1918 destroyed all the records. The cemetery does look to be in good condition though, and I'll get to why in just a minute. This is the only grave out here with a name on it. L.A. McKay, 1914. The reason this cemetery is in the condition it is because a man named Roland would make the drive out here from Los Angeles to care for it several times a month for years. He passed away in 2017, and there is a small memorial here for him, but others have continued his work. So that's our look at the lost Route 66 ghost towns of Siberia and Baghdad. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing, and we'll see you next week.